A question that we get asked constantly here is, which software should I be choosing when I'm building a no-code app? Well, in this video, I'm going to be helping to solve this once and for all by pitting two different software against each other. Airtable, specifically Airtable interfaces, as they compare to Softer. Why would you build your front end in one tool over the other? Well, this is exactly what we're tackling in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full power of your no-code tool suite, whatever tools those are. And as I mentioned, we are going to be focusing on two of my personal favorite no-code tools, Airtable and Softer. Airtable I hold very near and dear to my heart because it is the one that started this channel. And Softer is one of the first tools that we picked up for that front-end capability inside of no-code. Now, before we jump into the guts of my reasoning here, I first want to start by saying that we actively use both of these tools. This is not necessarily saying that one tool is better than the others. My objective here is to help you understand where they kind of fit in the grand scheme of things so that when you're building your next project, you can make the best decision for you. Should you go one way or the other? Well, it really comes down to what particular use case you're trying to solve, and therefore which of these tools is going to be a better fit. Now, I also want to highlight that Airtable does a lot more that we're not going to be talking about in this video. Airtable has database components. They have a lot of internal automation components. We're not going to really hit on those in this video because we're going to be focusing on the front end experience. That is how it compares to Softer. Softer is a front end application builder, and Airtable's interfaces are how we can build something on the front end, share it with people on our team, and give them the right level of permission. Make sure they see what we want them to see, make sure they can edit what we want them to edit. Both of these software give us that capability, and so that's what we're going to be pitting head to head in this video. Now, as we jump into things here, I want to first invite you to follow along with me. If you already have your own Softer account, go ahead and pull that up, and you can go to the different places that I'm highlighting in this video. If you're not already using Softer, please consider signing up using our link. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. Softer has graciously given our audience a 1 month trial of their pro account. If you want to take advantage of that, when you sign up for Softer, go ahead and log in and put in this coupon code gap_1month_pro. I'll be sure to include this coupon description with the video as well so that you can get one free month at Softer. Go ahead and open that up and start following along with us. Now, the first thing I can say about Softer is that it allows for more complex building of portals. Whether you're doing an internal portal, an internal workflow management tool, or some sort of external facing portal that you're sharing with clients or shareholders or someone else, well, Softer is really going to win out, particularly on the external facing side of things. Airtable is not really a good application, a good software for building things that are external. And the reason for that is when you build an interface in Airtable, you are required to pay per user. Each user is going to incur a charge on your Airtable plan. That is not the case with Softer. With Softer, we pay for whatever our level of permission is, whatever tier we are on, but then we can share our application with external users. And so in some cases, that's thousands of users that we can grant access to our application. So in particular, this really shines when we're doing things with those external use cases. Now, to kind of piggyback on this same bullet point, when building external use cases, there are integrations that Softer has made available that Airtable just doesn't have. I'm thinking about things like an integration natively with Stripe. So for example, if you wanted to sell courses online, or if you wanted to create a membership or something like that, that would be an external facing type of application that you would not want to build in an Airtable interface. Of course, you'd incur massive software charges building that internal to Airtable. But with Softer, you can also process payment directly through Stripe inside of your portal. You can share it with people externally. The capabilities of building your web application is much more robust than you would just for an internal facing interface. Now, the second point here is that Sofdr has more advanced permissions available than Airtable interfaces, specifically around areas of showing certain information conditionally or making it conditionally editable. Yes, it's true that within an Airtable interface, we have some controls and permissions, but generally what we do is we build an interface page and then we share it with somebody. And whatever level of permission we are granting inside of that page, whether a field is editable or even visible, well, everybody who has that thing shared with them is going to have the same permission level inside of the interface. That is not true with Sofdr. Sofdr's advanced permissions allow us to share it with different types of users. Let's say that you were building an internal application that had five different internal roles. You have like an owner role, a manager role, etc. You can set different permissions on everything inside of Sofdr. So who can see it? What can they edit? Can they create new records? All of this is entirely customizable based on the user role that's associated with the account that's logging into Sofdr. And so huge advantage here when we are building those more robust applications that require conditional visibility, conditional editing capabilities. Now, I also need to highlight that Sofdr has a new feature called conditional forms, which allows us to put certain things in our forms and make it visible under certain circumstances. Depending on what people answer within the form, depending on who they are as a user, you can edit or cultivate what they can see in that form. This allows us to build more robust applications inside, again, piggybacking on the idea that we have more advanced user permissions. If we're to compare to the native Airtable forms, this is not available. There is such a thing as conditional visibility inside of Airtable interfaces, but this is an enterprise required feature at this point, meaning that you must be on the very, very highest of the Airtable pricing plans. Now, that's not the case with Sofdr. You have multiple different levels inside of their payment options that will allow you to have this kind of conditional visibility, conditional editability, and even activate those conditional forms. Now, the third point is something I touched on briefly already, but it has to do with those licenses. As a reminder, everyone who you give access to an Airtable interface is going to incur a user charge for whatever plan you're on. And this is true for anybody who can edit information inside of the interface. You can grant read-only access to your Airtable interface. You will not incur a charge for read-only access. But let's be honest, read-only access doesn't really allow your users to do much. All they can do is see the information. They can't even comment or write notes on it. So if you give them any kind of editing or commenting access inside of Airtable interfaces, they will incur a charge per user based on whatever plan or tier you are on for your Airtable plan. So if you're on that highest plan, whatever your per user cost is, even if you only let them edit one field, you're paying whatever that seat license is for every user that you give that access to. Now, contrast that again to Sofdr. Inside of Sofdr, we are able to give access to thousands of external users, and in some cases, hundreds of internal users to the tool without incurring additional charge per user. So obviously, this is going to give us a lot of potential when launching those applications, especially, as I mentioned earlier, external facing applications that are just not a great fit for the Airtable interface. Now, the fourth thing that Sofdr allows for is adding a custom domain and removing that Sofdr branding when you launch your application. So if you're trying to cultivate a very unique brand feel, you can do this inside of a front-end application builder like Sofdr. That is not the case with an Airtable interface. This kind of goes along with the previous idea that in order to log into an Airtable interface, I have to be logging in to an Airtable license. So in any condition where you might want to have full control over your branding and the customer experience or whoever it is that's logging into your portal, well, Airtable interfaces really won't be the right fit because of the fact that that Airtable branding will be there. People are creating an Airtable account to get in. As opposed to, if you build your application in Sofdr, you share it, you put it on your own custom domain, something you can't do in Airtable, you can also then send emails that come directly from your system and really cultivate that experience, not to mention branding of the website, making sure that your entire application has the same look and feel as your brand. Now, my next point is all about web accessibility, both on the computer or laptop, but most importantly, in your mobile phone or mobile device. So software, when you're building inside of it, allows you to see exactly what your web application looks like in a laptop or a tablet or even the mobile device as you're building. You can just one touch, one click, and see exactly what that experience would be like. Now, yes, it's true that Airtable interfaces are also largely available on a mobile device, but they're not always optimized specifically for that mobile experience, which is different from software. In software, you build that one application, and yes, it is available across all of your different devices, immediately deployable. But most importantly, it also has the capability of being launched into a PWA or progressive web application. This essentially means that your users, with just a few clicks, can install your app, your very web application that you built in software. They can just install it, download it right to their mobile device or tablet. And this, again, allows you to have such a different branding and overall customization control that you're offering to your users. This is not something that we get in the Airtable interfaces experience because we're not downloading a separate application. Within Airtable, again, people are logging in as Airtable users. They are not getting a true customized experience. Now, the last point that I really love to hammer home for people who are considering software over Airtable is that when you're building an application in software, it's kind of database agnostic, meaning wherever your information lives, it's probably cool. Just keep it there. And the front end experience is what you build in software. And where this really shines is when you have different components, different data sets that you want to put together into one application and tie it all into one thing. Maybe you're storing some information in a spreadsheet on Google Sheets. Maybe you're storing other information in HubSpot or in Airtable or in Smart Suite. That's perfectly fine. You can call upon all of these different data sources, bring them into your software application, and show how all of this data comes together. Now, of course, as you might expect, if you're building an Airtable interface, it requires that you have all of your data living in Airtable. Now, I don't have anything against saying you should build a single source of truth. In fact, I firmly believe that every business, every organization should own its own single source of truth. So yes, put your data in one place, consolidate it as much as possible. But there are plenty of times where you might have different databases, different things working for different departments. And this is where software shines. You can put together that application so that everybody can access all the data that you need them to see, but you don't have to move that data. You don't have to switch it around. You don't have to integrate it into a new tool. This is going to save you a ton of money when you go to build your web application. If you have your data in a reliable database already that integrates with software, you're already done. That's 90% of the job right there. Whereas with Airtable, you're going to have to bring that data into Airtable. You're going to have to build your own database schema. You have to link all your information together before you can put together your Airtable interface. So I know we went hard here for why software beats out on the Airtable side of things, but I do want to stress that Airtable interfaces have a time and place. Internal tooling where you're already using Airtable, where all your data lives there, where you don't need a progressive web application, Airtable's a great pick. And as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we use both internally. We have internal Airtable interfaces, we have external portals that we've built inside of software, and all of it works together beautifully. The important part that I hope you took away from this is when you should use one tool over the other, and understanding the key differences between them is the first step. As a closing thought, if you are just now getting into no-code and you would like to really level up, the best way I can help you is with some free automation training that you can grab right now at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. This training is going to teach you, no matter what tool you're using, how to think about no-code automation so you can start reclaiming your valuable time. That's it for this video. Leave any questions or comments you have below. And in the meantime, keep on building.